Prasad, standing here with my friends Salza and Shreya to present ourselves. At first, I would like to thank our respected promoter for giving us such a golden opportunity to present ourselves in front of you all. And our today's topic is on killing it. It is a poem written by Jeev Patel. In this, the poem is saying that it is not easy to kill a tree. It is very time consuming. The jab of a knife can't kill a tree. And all the trees used to get all the nutrients, sunlight, air and water, which used to make the tree much stronger. And also in the second time, the poet says that if you want to kill a tree, first you should took out the root outside of the soil, and then you have to leave it outside. Then all the sun, light, air and water, it will come go outside and the tree will be dying. And now for saying further information, I'd like to call Shreya.
Good afternoon, everyone. Me and my presentation partners are here to present a topic called On Killing a Tree, written by Jeev Patel. Jeev Patel is an Indian author, writer or painter. He's a very famous author of India. So he has written many books and poems and stories. One of them is On Killing a Tree. Today I'm going to present that poem, the summary of the presentation. So On Killing a Tree is a really sensitive poem. The writer pursues to the reader not to destroy a tree, and killing the tree equates with the killing of a human being. He says that a small plant needs sunlight, minerals, nutrients, and many other things to, and gradually grows up into a huge tree. It develops a strong trunk, then several numerous leaves. So If one is cutting the trunk of a tree, that doesn't mean it is destroying the whole entire tree. It is not, the whole tree isn't destroyed by just cutting the trunk. The trunk which has been cut will just bleed like a wounded man. And once the wound is healed completely, then there will be a growth of tiny branches and leaves. Then he says that in order to destroy a tree completely, you have to uproot that tree entirely with the roots which are present inside the soil, which are white in pigment and they are moist with the soil. So now I would like to call Shailja to say for more.
So the topic on killing a tree, it is written by a great poet, Jeev Patel. He was an Indian poet and he used the themes for this poem as like actually taunts the people that we should cut the tree. Don't say them, don't cut the tree. He taunt them and say that how we should cut the tree, why we should cut the tree. So in first stanza, it says that like the trees can't be cut down easily. It takes a lot of time because trees are grown up with the presence of sunlight, water, air, minerals they grab from the core of the earth. So a jab of knife can't cut the tree, can't put down the tree, because the trunks of those trees have become very hard, letting those all minerals present in the biosphere. It needs a lot of strength. If we simply put a axe once on the trunk of the tree, nothing will happen to that tree, because it will just be like a wound which normal people get in their body. So we need to put a lot of strength. We have to hammer on them many times so that it gets down. When a tree is cut off, it doesn't die because the root is still there. A new pigment will start growing from that root. So if you want really the tree to be died, just uproot it from its root. Now, this was the theme and explanation given by the poet in this topic. Now I'd like to ask some questions to our students. Now the first question is, IUC, who is the author of this poem? Right. Thank you. Ashutosh, if we want the tree to be completely die, what we should do?
We have to uproot it from the road.
Thank you. Abhishek, Why with the hammer of one single axe the tree can't die?
Because it gets the minerals and sunlight from sun and some minerals from the core of the earth.
Thank you.